Allez, bonjour à tous, bonjour. Hope that you're doing fine. I am in a good shape, in fact, today, so I hope that you are too. Let's have a look at the persons who are here. Stardust is with us. Bonjour Stardust, comment ça va? Yvette est là aussi, Roman, bonjour. Morita est là aussi, Paul est avec nous, Annabelle est là, coucou Annabelle, comment ça va? Liliana est là aussi, Cosmina, bonjour, Sally est avec nous, Gloria, bonjour, bonjour, Yesero est là, bonjour Yesero, qui est-ce qu'il y a d'autre? Let me check, because now you've been talking, Renato is here, Roman is here too, they're discussing about football, so is there a match? I'm not really into football, but I hope that everything will go fine, Roman, if it's your team, go for it. Allez-y. Mercurial Man is here too. J. Vincent, bonjour. Let me check. Carly is here. Amira too. Esma, bonjour. Fatima. Hilary is here. So let me check. Ah, Cherylyn est là aussi. Well, I guess everybody is here. Lisa is here. Bonjour, Lisa. Ice Cubes. Good shape. Non, j'ai pas couru. Non, not really have the time now to run, but c'était un peu difficile. C'était un peu difficile. So there is a good news and it's right there. Look, dimanche 11 juillet à 13h, Jardin du Luxembourg, I will be there. If you want to meet and have a drink, it will be the possibility to meet. So dimanche 11 juillet à 13h, Jardin du Luxembourg, because I like this place. I think it's quite nice. And then if we want to have a drink after, it's really possible and it's nicer maybe around Saint-Michel when we can cross the bridge and go to Châtelet or Les Halles. But I mean, it's a nice place. Dimanche 11 juillet, 13h, je serai là. TV is asking, where is that hair? I don't know. I lost them a while ago. I was looking, didn't find them. I'm just like that now. That's just the beauty about it. I don't really need to worry about having my hair in the wrong direction in the morning. This is a beautiful thing. Allez, la personne du jour, the person of the day, is this incredible, incredible singer. I don't know if you know her, but her name is Melody Gardot. She's got such a great voice and all the music that she does is really, really nice. So I've been taking some interviews of her when she speaks French, and then we will work on the interview today. So Melody Gardot, let's discover her with few things as usual. So I will read it and then you just need to write the missing words. Et on commence. First thing, Melody Joy Gardot, née le 2 février 1985 dans l'état du New Jersey aux États-Unis, est une auteure, compositrice, interprète et musicienne américaine. Melody Joy Gardot, née le 2 février 1985 dans l'État du New Jersey aux États-Unis, est une auteure, compositrice, interprète et musicienne américaine. Allez-y, please write the missing words. Alors, I can see that you are already sending the things. I hope that the connection is good. I'm always looking at the things, but apparently it's not bad. So the first thing that we were looking for was nicht, as usual. When it's the feminine form, we should put the final e. Remember that you don't pronounce it, but it should be written an e accent aigu with the e in the end. After that, dans, D-A-N-S. Stardust is still struggling with the sound. Qu'est-ce qui se passe, Stardust? You've got some difficulties lately. Aux États-Unis. Oh, remember, it will be when you put the preposition A with the article les, it will become O-A-U-X. And then, first thing, auteur, we need to put the feminine form, remember, A-U-T-E-U-R. So add the feminine form here, because the masculine would be auteur, A-U-T-E-U-R, but it's possible to put the feminine here too. So compositrice, feminine form of compositeur, C-O-M-P-O-S-I-T-R-I-C-E. Mélodie Joy Gardot, née le 2 février 1985 dans l'État du New Jersey aux États-Unis, est une auteure, compositrice, interprète et musicienne américaine. Allez, let's go for the second thing. Le 11 novembre 2003, alors qu'elle fait du vélo à Philadelphie, Mélodie Gardot est renversée par un conducteur qui n'a pas respecté un feu rouge. Le 11 novembre 2003, alors qu'elle fait du vélo à Philadelphie, Mélodie Gardot est renversée par un conducteur qui n'a pas respecté un feu rouge. Please write the missing words. Alors, alloc, rage, why not en l'état? Well, because this is the preposition that you need to use for l'état. Dans l'état de. Allez, let's have a look at the things that were missing. The first one, alors. And in fact, you've been writing it quite properly. Remember that you put a S in the end. Oh, I can see that Julia joined us too. Bonjour, Julia, comment ça va? And Cassandra too. I'm not sure if I said hello to everybody. I'm sorry about that. Manon, same thing. Bonjour, bonjour. And Olga too. Allez, so alors, you write it A-L-O-R-S. D'accord? Second thing, vélo. Remember that, well, in some cases we can use bicyclette, but in most of the cases we'll tend to use vélo. It's masculine. Un vélo. And you write it V-E accent aigu L-O. Un vélo. After that, it's renversé. Renversé should definitely be in the feminine form here, because we're talking about mélodie. And so renversé is R-E-N-V-E-R-S-E, accent aigu, E. And finally, respecter. Respecter, past participle of the verb respecter, because here it's in the passé composé form, A, respecter. And so you should write it R-E-S-P-E-C-T-E, accent aigu. Le 11 novembre 2003, alors qu'elle fait du vélo à Philadelphie, Mélodie Gardot est renversée par un conducteur qui n'a pas respecté un feu rouge. Allez, let's have a look at the third thing regarding Mélodie Gardot. Sévèrement polytraumatisé, crâne, colonne vertébrale et bassin, elle est clouée sur un lit d'hôpital pendant environ un an. Sévèrement polytraumatisé, crâne, colonne vertébrale et bassin, elle est clouée sur un lit d'hôpital pendant environ un an. Please write the missing words. Alors, I can see that it starts to arrive. The first thing, sévèrement, remember that it's an adverb. It is an adverb and in fact, it is here connected to the adjective polytraumatisé. So, sévèrement is coming from the adjective sévère, remember, and then you add ment in the end to get this adverb de manière. Sévèrement, you write it. S, E accent aigu, V, E accent grave, R, E, M, E, N, T. Sévèrement. Sévèrement. Vertébral, it's an adjective. Vertébral will be exactly the same thing if it's feminine or masculine. In that case, colonne is a feminine noun. Une colonne, so it's vertébral in the feminine form. Vertébral, you write it V-E-R-T-E, accent aigu, B-R-A-L-E. And then after that, clouée, hein, elle est clouée, so it should be definitely the feminine form, because we are still talking about Melody, C-L-O-U-E, accent aigu, E. And finally, hôpital, substantive, and it's a masculine word, so un hôpital, you write it H-O, accent circonflexe, P-I-T-A-L, un hôpital. Sévèrement polytraumatisé, crâne, colonne vertébrale et bassin, elle est clouée sur un lit d'hôpital pendant environ un an. Allez, let's continue with the fourth thing, numéro 4. Parmi les séquelles de son traumatisme crânien, la plus évidente est une hypersensibilité à la lumière qui l'oblige à porter des lunettes teintées en permanence. Parmi les séquelles de son traumatisme crânien, la plus évidente est une hypersensibilité à la lumière qui l'oblige à porter des lunettes teintées en permanence. Please write the missing words. Alors, Victoria Thomas nous rejoint. Bonjour, comment ça va? And Tsering too. Bonjour Tsering, comment ça va? Let's have a look at the things. The first one is a substantive, it's a noun, and it's traumatisme. And you can see that it's masculine. Hein? Un traumatisme, le traumatisme. You write it T-R-A-U-M-A-T-I-S-M-E. After that, évidente, hein, évident in that case, well, should be in the feminine form because it's connected to les séquelles. Séquelles is a feminine noun. So, la plus évidente, évidente, you will write it E, accent aigu, V-I-D-E-N-T-E. After that, lumière, lumière, it's a noun, it's a substantive and it's feminine, la lumière. Une lumière, L-U-M-I-E, accent grave, R-E. And finally, it's permanence. You've been writing it quite well in most of the cases. Permanence, remember that you write it P-E-R-M-A-N-E-N-C-E. En permanence. Parmi les séquelles de son traumatisme crânien, la plus évidente est une hypersensibilité à la lumière qui l'oblige à porter des lunettes teintées en permanence. Allez, on continue. Numéro 5, number 5. Mélodie Gardot décrit ce handicap comme escalader le mont Everest tous les jours, car elle se réveille souvent sans se souvenir de ce qu'elle a à faire dans la journée. Mélodie Gardot décrit ce handicap comme escalader le mont Everest tous les jours, car elle se réveille souvent sans se souvenir de ce qu'elle a à faire dans la journée. Please write the missing words. Alors, Alberto nous rejoint. Bonjour Alberto et Luciana aussi. Bonjour Luciana, comment ça va? Allez, let's have a look at the words. The first one is the verb décrire. Décrire belongs to the third group. In that case, you need to conjugate it to the third person of the singular. Elle décrit, and you write it D-E, accent aigu, C-R-I-T. After that, escalader, well, it's the infinitive form of the verb. Verb from the first group, regular verb, and you write it E-S-C-A-L-A-D-E. R, escalader. After that, same thing here, another infinitive, but as you can see, it's a pronominal verb, se souvenir. Hein? So obviously, you will put the se first, S-E, then after that, the verb souvenir is written, S-O-U-V-E-N-I-R. And finally, journée, journée, it's a noun, it's a substantive, and it's feminine, une journée, la journée, and you write it G-O-U-R-N-E, accent aigu, E. Allez, Mélodie Gardot décrit ce handicap comme escalader le mont Everest tous les jours, car elle se réveille souvent sans se souvenir de ce qu'elle a à faire dans la journée. Let's continue, numéro 6. Musicalement, son style mélange les influences du jazz vocal, du folk, du fado et de la bossa nova. Musicalement, son style mélange les influences du jazz vocal, du folk, du fado et de la bossa nova. Please write the missing words. Alors, let's have a look at the words. The first one is an adverb. Hein? The adverb is coming here from the adjective musical. Hein? Remember, the way to construct these adverbs of manner, so the one that will end with ment, it's normally, we've got some exceptions, but normally the way to do it, you take the adjective in the masculine form. In that case, it's musical, A-L. You will put the feminine form with the E in that case, musical, A-L-E. And after that, you add this ment in the end, and you will get your adverb. Musical, masculine form, musical, feminine form, with the E, you add the ment, musicalement. So you write it M-U-S-I-C-A-L-E-M-E-N-T, musicalement. The verb after is the verb mélanger. Mélanger, regular verb from the first group. In that case, you need to conjugate it in the present. Third person, of the singular. Mélange, M-E, accent aigu, L-A-N-G-E. And finally, influence. Influence, it's a feminine noun. Une influence. Here, it's the plural form. So, with S in the end, I-N-F-L-U-E-N-C-E. S. Musicalement, son style mélange les influences du jazz vocal, du folk, du fado et de la bossa nova. Allez, numéro 7. Number 7. Elle dit être influencée aussi bien par des artistes de blues ou de jazz que par des artistes de folk, de pop, de rock ou issus du répertoire classique. Elle dit être influencée aussi bien par des artistes de blues ou de jazz que par des artistes de folk, de pop, de rock ou issus du répertoire classique. Please write the missing words. Alors, let's have a look at the things. The first one is influencer. Once again, it should be in the feminine form because we're talking about melody. So, influencer with the E in the end to mark the feminine in I-N-F-L-U-E-N-C-E, accent aigu, E. Remember that, of course, we will pronounce the two, I mean, the same way, whether it's masculine or feminine, but don't forget to write the feminine form in the end. After that, artiste, artiste, and in that case, it's the plural form. So remember that artiste, it can be an artiste, une artiste, it will be exactly the same way to write it, but it does exist for the two genders. So un artiste, une artiste, in that case, it's the plural, so A-R-T-E. I-S-T-E-S. After that, folk, as you can see, we write it like in other languages, not all of them, but quite many, F-O-L-K. And finally, issue. Issue should be here in the plural form. And when we say plural form, we talk about the basic plural, so it includes men and women, so it means that it's the masculine plural. This is the way it is, you know how it goes. I-S-S-U. S, issue. It should be the plural here because we're talking about des artistes. It's the plural concept. Elle dit être influencée aussi bien par des artistes de blues ou de jazz que par des artistes de folk, de pop, de rock ou issus du répertoire classique. Merci. Thank you. Allez, on y va, le français de Marseille. So you remember that we've been starting that, a while ago, and we will continue a bit. So we will continue to work on this interesting and beautiful accent that they have in Marseille. And it's always important for you to get used to different ways of, pronouncing French, because if you want to go in the south, and you should definitely go, well, they will talk like that. So let's continue with this interesting exercise of discovering, the French from Marseille. Up, on y va, as usual, we'll listen, and you will have to find the missing words. Attention, attention.
C'est quand il a vu ce bidonville qu'il a écrit la chanson. C'est quand il a vu ce bidonville qu'il a écrit la chanson. C'est quand il a vu ce bidonville qu'il a écrit la chanson. C'est quand il a vu ce bidonville qu'il a écrit la chanson. C'est quand il a vu ce bidonville qu'il a écrit la chanson. C'est quand il a vu ce bidonville qu'il a écrit la chanson. C'est quand il a vu ce bidonville qu'il a écrit la chanson.
Allez-y, s'il vous plaît.
C'est quand il a vu. C'est quand il a vu.
Allez, I was struggling with the thing. Once again. Alors, so, the words were quand, the first one. So remember that we've been seeing that previously. The nasal will be pronounced slightly different because for me, I will pronounce everything in the nose. Quand, quand, quand. I don't pronounce any N or ng after, but he does and they usually do in Marseille. So the second thing was vu. In fact, we will see, but there is not a big difference in the pronunciation. Écrit, and then chanson. So chanson, obviously, you will notice that there is a slight difference between his pronunciation and mine. Allez, on y va. Attention, let's listen to it. So first, the way I would pronounce it is, c'est quand il a vu ce bidonville qu'il a écrit la chanson. D'accord? He's going fast. He's going fast. We've been seeing that previously, but it's okay. Try, I will make it roll a few times. Try to look and try to listen at the same time. Hein? Read and listen, allez-y.
C'est quand il a vu ce bidonville qu'il a écrit la chanson. C'est quand il a vu ce bidonville qu'il a écrit la chanson. C'est quand il a vu ce bidonville qu'il a écrit la chanson.
D'accord, so you probably noticed that the main difference between him and me, well, first the pace, but then, well, I can go fast if I want. I don't really feel like going fast, in fact. But the second thing will be the nasal. So I will pronounce quand. I will pronounce bidonville. So everything is going in the nose and you don't hear any N. Bidonville. And the last one, chanson. Chanson, no N at all, everything in the nose. Quand, bidonville, chanson. So let's listen to him one more time because you will feel that he's going for the N in the end.
C'est quand il a vu ce bidonville qu'il a écrit la chanson.
Voilà. So the main difference, as you can hear, quand. I mean, it's not, I don't make the accent because I'm so bad with that, but when I pronounce quand, he will pronounce.
C'est quand il a vu ce bidonville qu'il a écrit la chanson.
So you can hear the N or the ng after. So let's continue with numéro 2. Numéro 2, here it is. Same thing here, you will have to find the missing words.
Une fois, je suis allé au musée avec deux collègues à moi. Une fois, je suis allé au musée avec deux collègues à moi. Une fois, je suis allé au musée avec deux collègues à moi. Une fois, je suis allé au musée avec deux collègues à moi. Une fois, je suis allé au musée avec deux collègues à moi. Une fois, je suis allé au musée avec deux collègues à moi. Une fois, je suis allé au musée avec deux collègues à moi.
Allez-y. Sherilyn, well, she's fast, huh, Sherilyn, because it's just like with the colleagues. But if I remember, you said they were coming from, it was Toulouse, Montpellier, and Bordeaux. Bordeaux, I mean, the accent is extremely thin. I mean, it must be almost non-existent. Alors voilà, so the sentence was une fois je suis allé au musée avec deux collègues à moi. D'accord, so you are supposed to find fois, aller, musée, and then collègue. So let's have a look now and let's see how he pronounces the thing.
Une fois je suis allé au musée avec deux collègues à moi.
So in fact, it's not
really... Une fois, je suis allé au musée avec deux collègues à moi.
Voilà. It's not really difficult. I mean, difficult or different, I should say, in that case. Une fois, je suis allé. So this is the way it goes. And remember, we saw that previously. Je suis will become je suis. Hein? We just remove the E and after that we contract je suis allé au musée avec deux collègues à moi. I'm just pronouncing approximately the same way. Une fois, je suis allé au musée avec deux collègues à moi.
Une fois, je suis allé au musée avec deux collègues à moi.
Yeah. In that case...
Une fois, je suis allé au musée avec deux collègues à moi.
Right. In that case, there is not a lot of difference between well, him and me. Allez, on y va. Numéro 3. Numéro 3, let's go for it. Attention, attention.
Ben, je vous présente mon mari, mes enfants, mon vide ordure. Ben, je vous présente mon mari, mes enfants, mon vide ordure. Ben, je vous présente mon mari, mes enfants, mon vide ordure. Ben, je vous présente mon mari, mes enfants, mon vide ordure.
Allez-y. Alors, oui, hein, so in that case, well, we were looking for three things, hein, so présente, hein, so the nasal one more time, and congratulations, because now you can catch it quite well, so because once again, on this nasal, it's a bit slightly pronounced differently, so mari, not really different in that case, but then enfant, nasal is coming back, so we'll see that clearly it's pronounced differently, well, in both of our cases. So I would pronounce it ben je vous présente. So I'm going for the en in my nose. Mon mari, mes enfants, mon vide d'ordure. Allez, attention, on y va.
Présente mon mari, mes enfants, mon vide d'ordure.
So you can hear the présente is quite different. Listen to it.
Ben, je vous présente mon mari, mes enfants, mon vide ordure.
Voilà, très bien. J. Vincent, strange family. No, he was explaining in this interview, of course it makes sense, I'm slicing the thing. It was just for phonetical purpose, but he was explaining the fact that first he was living in a slum, and after that they moved in a place where it was possible to have the garbage disposal that they didn't have when they were living in the previous place. So this is the reason why his mother was so proud to have this possibility of having this garbage disposal that she was introducing the garbage disposal as a member of the family. She was extremely proud of that. So, je vous présente mon mari, mes enfants, mon vide d'ordure.
Ben, je vous présente mon mari, mes enfants, mon vide d'ordure.
Voilà, très bien. That's the reason why she's introducing the vide ordure as well. Allez, you need to be brave for this one because I've been removing everything, d'accord?
Ma mère, elle était ravie. 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 Ma mère, elle était ravie.
Allez-y. Alors voilà, hein, the sentence was ma mère, elle était ravie. And so once again, we're talking about the garbage disposal, le vide ordure. She was pleased to have it. Ma mère, elle était ravie. So let's see now if there is a big or slight difference between the two of us. I would pronounce it ma mère, elle était ravie.
Ma mère, elle était ravie.
I don't feel any big difference between him and me in that case. Ma mère, elle était ravie.
Ma mère, elle était ravie.
It's quite the same, in fact. The R, the mère, it's...
Ma mère, elle était ravie.
No, it's the same. Ma mère, elle était ravie. So I would pronounce it exactly the same. So in that case, we don't really have a big difference. Allez, and now we're talking about where they were living before. On y va.
C'était un bidonville qui était en bas de la gare Saint-Charles. C'était un bidonville qui était en bas de la gare Saint-Charles. C'était un bidonville qui était en bas de la gare Saint-Charles. C'était un bidonville qui était en bas de la gare Saint-Charles. C'était un bidonville qui était en bas de la gare Saint-Charles. C'était un bidonville qui était en bas de la gare Saint-Charles. C'était un bidonville qui était en bas de la gare Saint-Charles.
Allez-y. Alors, look at the sentence. C'était... Was it c'était? I've got a doubt now. Let's check it one more time. I've been putting c'était, but maybe...
C'était un bidonville qui était en bas de la gare Saint-Charles.
Sorry about that. It was not c'était, it was c'est. Which is strange because basically it's talking about the past. But no. Let me check.
C'était un bidonville qui était en bas de la gare Saint-Charles.
Voilà, oui. The first part, it's c'est. Hein? It's not c'était, as I've been putting first. So obviously, in the translation, it should be boom. Voilà. So, c'est un bidonville. So once again, probably the pronunciation will be slightly different here. Hein? Bidonville, because I go for the nasal here. And qui était... En bas de la gare Saint-Charles. Saint might be different too. Let's check. So I will pronounce. C'est un bidonville qui était en bas de la gare Saint-Charles.
C'est un bidonville qui était en bas de la gare Saint-Charles.
Mm. So you can hear probably the ng after the nasal. Hein? So un, it's slightly different. Bidonville, obviously, will be different. And en bas, it's slightly different too. Let's check that.
C'est un bidonville qui était en bas de la gare Saint-Charles.
Okay, so take the time, I will make it roll twice. Take the time to try to read it at the same time and catch these nasales that are pronounced slightly differently. On y va.
C'est un bidonville qui était en bas de la gare Saint-Charles. C'est un bidonville qui était en bas de la gare Saint-Charles.
That's it. So... You will become specialist with the français from Marseille, and after that you can go there and speak with the accent. They will be so pleased. Alors, Sukanya is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour. Alors, la personne du jour, it is Mélodie Gardeau. So we've been discovering her and now we will work on, well, the things that she will say. So let's start with the first thing. So, of course, I wanted you to get used to her way of, well, speaking French. So I didn't give full translations first or full sentences. D'accord? Be careful.
C'est parce qu'il a beaucoup d'improvisation. 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 C'est parce qu'il a beaucoup d'improvisation.
Allez-y, please write the missing words. Alors, let's have a look at the sentence. C'est parce qu'il y a beaucoup d'improvisation. So, of course, we'll have to see if there is something to say about the pronunciation, which is totally okay, but I think that, and I'm not sure if it's the same for you, but still, it was, the flow is really good. She's got her pace. Right now, I think that it was quite good.
C'est parce qu'il a beaucoup d'improvisation.
So maybe she was not going too strong on the il y a, but she went for the spoken ya, something closer to French, in fact, which is quite good. Improvisation, it's a bit, but we're used that even in France, the nasal, it can be discussed. So I can hear a little bit of N at the end of improvisation, but maybe it's because of me. Attention, on y va.
C'est parce qu'il a beaucoup d'improvisation.
Oui, but still, it's like, it's really clear. It is really, really clear. So, c'est parce qu'il y a beaucoup d'improvisation. Allez, let's go for the second thing. So, I thought that it might be nice also to give you a few words. So, try to find me the missing words.
Et ça veut dire on suit le moment aussi. Et ça veut dire on suit le moment aussi. Et ça veut dire on suit le moment aussi. Et ça veut dire on suit le moment aussi. Et ça veut dire on suit le moment aussi. Et ça veut dire on suit le moment aussi. Et ça veut dire on suit le moment aussi. Et ça veut dire on suit le moment aussi.
Allez-y. Alors, I can see that it's arriving. It's not really clear. J. Vincent, she said, I don't get it, but it's okay. Don't worry about that. So let's try to see exactly what she says. So, et ça veut dire qu'on suit le moment. I've been correcting a bit because, well, she went with another thing. So let's check that.
Et ça veut dire on suit le moment aussi.
Voilà. So first thing, in fact, she's been dropping le que. She said, et ça veut dire on suit le moment. So she's making a mistake here because basically the verb suivre, it's a tricky one. Je suis, tu suis, il, elle suit on suit. So she should say on suit, S-U-I-T, and not on suive. But it's not really a problem because in that case, when we hear that, I mean, we understand that it's the verb suivre. So that's the main point. Remember that. And it's extremely important for you when you want to speak. It's okay if you make these type of mistakes. She didn't conjugate the verb properly, but still I understood everything. So, et ça veut dire que, normally it should be here, she's been dropping it, but still it's clear. Et ça veut dire qu'on suit le moment. So let's listen to it one more time.
Et ça veut dire on suit le moment aussi.
Voilà, so she's dropping the que. It's a mistake, but still it's clear, and she's putting suive instead of suit, and it's okay because it is extremely, extremely clear. So one more time.
Et ça veut dire on suit le moment aussi.
Voilà. Allez, let's continue with numéro 3. So now you've got to give me all the things, please.
Si j'oublie les mots.
Allez-y. Alors, let's have a look at the sentence, and you've been catching everything, in fact. Hein? Si j'oublie les mots. And I think it was really well pronounced in that case. Let's go for it.
Si j'oublie les mots.
It's really good, in fact. Hein? Si j'oublie les mots. Everything is perfectly pronounced.
Si j'oublie les mots.
Yeah. The ou, it could be rounder, like a ou, but clearly it's like it's details. I mean, really details, just to say something, because in fact, it's perfect. One more time.
Si j'oublie les mots.
Oui, c'est très bien. Si j'oublie les mots, and she's been pronouncing the oubli quite well, remember, un verb oublier from the first group. You drop the final E, you don't pronounce it. J'oublie, tu oublies, il oublie. This is really, really good. Alors, numéro 4, attention, it's the same thing, and it's the full sentence that you've got to catch. Allez, on y va.
J'étais en train de faire un concert.
Allez-y. Alors, what's going on, Stardust? You can't do that with her. Is she talking too fast or is it... I don't know, in fact. It's quite interesting because this is something that is extremely difficult to explain, the fact that in some cases it's easier to understand what certain persons will say, and it might not be related to the pace or the accent, but it's just something that is difficult to explain. Alors, let's have a look at what she said. Hop là, voilà, regardez. So she said, j'étais en train de faire un concert. So in most of the cases, you've been catching the thing, which is quite good. Regarding the accent, so let's have a look at the way she pronounced it. So basically, I would pronounce it, j'étais en train de faire un concert. So I've been catching one little thing, let's check that.
J'étais en train de faire un concert.
Voilà. Maybe the only thing that I could Well, mansion would be the last word, concert, because basically it's not really open. She goes for the, well, something that is closer to the English pronunciation, in fact. So whereas in French, in French, we will open the eh, concert. It's really like a eh, eh, eh. J'étais en train de faire un concert. Really open. Let's listen to her.
J'étais en train de faire un concert.
Ouais, but same thing here. I mean, everything is clear. And this is the point. Don't stress too much about the pronunciation because as for her, I mean, it flows. It is quite good. I'm auto-correcting the thing in most of the cases, so it's not really a problem. J'étais en train de faire un concert. Alice, numéro 5, same thing here. You need to catch everything, and I'm pretty sure you can do it.
J'ai complètement oublié.
Allez-y. Oh, this is nice because Julia is telling to Stardust, I believe in you. And she's putting a big, big heart. A big heart. Alors là, c'est formidable. To rewrite it because strangely it disappeared. So j'ai complètement oublié. So in that case she is using the verb oublier in the passé composé tense. So it was quite good in fact. She's putting the complètement in the middle, which is quite good too for the compound tenses. Remember, this is the way we will put the adverb. So let's try to see now if there is something to say about the pronunciation.
J'ai complètement oublié.
Voilà. Maybe the only thing that we could mention would be the nasal for the OM. Hein? Well, same thing here. It's details because clearly it is really well pronounced. So it's just if we want to find some details, I could say that in fact she's pronouncing like they pronounce in the south of France. So it's not a problem. It's a good pronunciation depending on where you are and where you go. So I would pronounce the OM like a nasal. In fact, OM is like ON. It's D'accord? So let's check. J'ai complètement oublié. And she goes for...
J'ai complètement oublié.
Ouais, same thing here. I mean, it's really nice. It's really beautiful and it flows and that's the point. So yes, she's pronouncing it with the M, but it's not a problem. It's really not a problem. Merci beaucoup. En tout cas. And this is for Rachel Louis, this is for you. Merci. Bien joué. Eh oui. Voilà, you had the fireworks, Rachel Louis, just for you. It's to say thank you very much. Bien joué aussi. Don't forget to participate and to do the exercise with us. Hein. Merci beaucoup. Allez, on y va. And don't forget to meet me dimanche 11 juillet, 13h, Jardin du Luxembourg. I will be there. Alors, we've been starting Le Petit Prince, and especially with the verbs, because I thought that it might be a good, well, a good and interesting exercise, and especially I love Le Petit Prince, so you don't really have the choice in that case. I'm sorry about that. Let's start with numéro 6. So we are continuing, and this is the idea. We've been starting with the five first things, and we continue the story. Les grandes personnes m'ont conseillé de laisser de côté les dessins de serpents boa ouverts ou fermés et de m'intéresser plutôt à la géographie, à l'histoire, au calcul et à la grammaire. Les grandes personnes m'ont conseillé de laisser de côté les dessins de serpents boa ouverts ou fermés et de m'intéresser plutôt à la géographie, à l'histoire, au calcul et à la grammaire. S'il vous plaît, écrivez les mots qui manquent, so please write the missing verbs, sorry. Alors, let's have a look at the missing things. So the first thing is in fact the verb conseiller. And the verb conseiller, in that case, it's in the passé composé. So you can see that first you've got the helping verb, avoir. It's in the third person of the plural, ont, O-N-T. And after that you have the past participle, conseiller, C-O-N-S-E-I-L-L-E, accent aigu. Mon conseiller, ont conseillé. After that, you've got the verb laisser. Laisser should definitely be in the infinitive form because conseiller, de faire, de laisser, de partir. So this exercise is quite good because you can start to make your list of the verbs that will be constructed with prepositions and other verbs. In that case, conseiller, de, with another verb in the infinitive form. Laisser, so you write it L-A-I-S-S-E-R. And then after that you've got intéressé. So remember, intéressé, in that case, it's the infinitive form. I-N-T-E, accent aigu, R-E-S-S-E-R. M'intéresser, so you've got the pronoun before. Les grandes personnes m'ont conseillé de laisser de côté les dessins de serpents boa ouverts ou fermés et de m'intéresser plutôt à la géographie, à l'histoire, au calcul et à la grammaire. Let's agree that it's la grammaire and not la grand-mère like we had previously. La grammaire. Number 7. Numéro 7. Les grandes personnes ne comprennent jamais rien toutes seules. Et c'est fatigant pour les enfants de toujours leur donner des explications. Les grandes personnes ne comprennent jamais rien toutes seules. Et c'est fatigant pour les enfants de toujours leur donner des explications. Allez-y.
Thank you.
Allez, let's have a look at the world of verbs, and then I've been picking only two in that case. The first one is the verb comprendre, comprendre, remember that it's from the third group, so it can be a bit tricky to conjugate. It's a bit like prendre, in fact. So, comprenne, in that situation, it's the third person of the plural. Remember, it's a bit tricky. Je comprends, tu comprends, il, elle comprend, nous comprenons, vous comprenez, ils comprennent, elles comprennent. So this is the type of verbs that have three roots for the conjugation. First one for je, tu, il. Second one for nous, vous. And third one for il in the plural form. So here you will write it comprennent. And finally it's être, être, third person of the singular, est. Les grandes personnes ne comprennent jamais rien toutes seules, et c'est fatigant pour les enfants de toujours leur donner des explications. I really love this one. Allez, numéro 8. Numéro 8, you've got a lot of things to find now. J'ai donc dû choisir un autre métier et j'ai appris à piloter des avions. J'ai volé un peu partout dans le monde. J'ai donc dû choisir un autre métier et j'ai appris à piloter des avions. J'ai volé un peu partout dans le monde. Please write the missing verbs. Alors, Rachel, my children are enjoying watching you. AB and Ali, dire merci. Alors, AB, coucou, bonjour, bonjour. And Ali, bonjour, bonjour. I hope you're doing fine. And you need to learn French because it's a funny language. Ali, let's have a look at the missing things. So the first thing is, in fact, the verb devoir. So it's the verb devoir. You have this passé composé form. So, passé composé form is j'ai dû. But you can see that we've got between the two this adverb donc. J'ai donc dû. D'accord? So, in that case, it means that, well, devoir is constructed with avoir for sure. So, it's est. After that, dû, you will pronounce it dû. You write it with the accent circonflexe on the U for a good reason, it's just to avoid mixing it with, well, du, je veux du café, so you need to be careful about that. Choisir should be in the infinitive form, remember, devoir, the verb that comes after without any preposition, should be in the infinitive. Choisir, C-H-O-I-S-I-R-E. After that, you've got the verb apprendre. Apprendre, as you can see here, it's in the passé composé form, avoir, and then past participle is appris, A-P-P-R-I-S. Apprendre, a, preposition, a, and then the verb should be in the infinitive. Same thing, write, make a list of all the verbs that you encounter and the structure that they are requiring after. So, apprendre, a, and the verb is in the infinitive, piloter, P-I-L-O-T-E-R. And finally, it's the verb voler. Verb voler, it's a regular verb, so it's from the first group. Of course, when you put that in the passé composé form, you use avoir as a helping verb, and then you put just your past participle voler with the accent. J'ai voler. So one important thing about this flying concept, because it's slightly different between French and English. In French, we consider that the persons can't fly. The only one who can fly is, in fact, pilots. They can say, je vole, because, in fact, somehow they're flying. The passengers, they're not using the word, I mean, we're not using voler. We say prendre l'avion. And this is quite important. So remember, for us, for French people, French-speaking persons, the only one who can fly, the birds, and then the pilots. The others, they just take the plane. J'ai donc dû choisir un autre métier et j'ai appris à piloter des avions. J'ai volé un peu partout dans le monde. Allez-y. Allez, it continues. On y va, numéro 9. Et la géographie, c'est exact, m'a beaucoup servi. Je savais reconnaître, du premier coup d'œil, la Chine de l'Arizona. C'est utile, si l'on est égaré pendant la nuit. Et la géographie, c'est exact, m'a beaucoup servi. Je savais reconnaître, du premier coup d'œil, la Chine de l'Arizona. C'est utile si l'on est égaré pendant la nuit. Please write the missing verbs. Alors, Rachel, what's going on? So you want another one and you will get another one. Merci Rachel, merci beaucoup. Thank you very much. Allez, voilà, voilà. Merci beaucoup, Rachel. But don't forget to write the verbs, hein, because I am checking if everybody is working, because it's a class. Hein? Let's not forget that. So we're looking for all these verbs. The first one is être in the present tense, est. After that, it's a verb, the verb servir, that is conjugated one more time in the passé composé. So you've got avoir, helping verb. And after that, you've got servi, past participle, a servi. After that, the verb savoir, that is in the imparfait form, remember? Imparfait form, in that case, it's savais, je savais, S-A-V-A-I-S. As you can see, the verb that will be following savoir must be in the imperative, infinitive form, and it's reconnaître, R-E-C-O-N-N-A-I. T-R-E. And finally, no, you get to, well, the verb être, I mean, clearly, it was just for the pleasure, E-S-T, you should know it by now, and you do, because I'm looking at your things. And after that, est égaré, so I can see that, who is asking, est égaré? Ah, d'accord, non, Stardust is putting some question marks. Est égaré, in that case, remember, remember that in that situation, in fact, est égaré, you should use it in a masculine form because you're talking about on, and on by definition, it is the basic form. So masculine is the basic form and it should be égaré without any E in the end, E-S-T, and then after that, égaré. Allez, let's continue and let's finish with numéro 10. Oh no, I forgot to read it, sorry. Wanted to read it with the things. Et la géographie, c'est exact, m'a beaucoup servi. Je savais reconnaître, du premier coup d'œil, la Chine de l'Arizona. C'est utile si l'on est égaré pendant la nuit. And now, numéro 10. J'ai ainsi eu, au cours de ma vie, des tas de contacts avec des tas de gens sérieux. J'ai beaucoup vécu chez les grandes personnes. Je les ai vus de très près. Ça n'a pas trop amélioré mon opinion. J'ai ainsi eu, au cours de ma vie, des tas de contacts avec des tas de gens sérieux. J'ai beaucoup vécu chez les grandes personnes. Je les ai vus de très près. Ça n'a pas trop amélioré mon opinion. Please write the missing verbs. Allez, on y va, let's have a look. So the first thing is the verb avoir in the passé composé form, j'ai eu. Hein? So this is the thing, so between them you get ainsi. After that, the second thing is the verb vivre in the passé composé form, j'ai vécu. But then you've got beaucoup between the two. Hein? As you can see, I mean, when we talk about the compound tenses, when you squeeze some adverbs, it goes between them. So this is the reason why it can be tricky. And that's the reason why I want to do this type of exercises for you to get used to that. So, j'ai vécu, remember, it's the verb vivre. Tricky past participle, this verb vivre, because it's vécu. Vécu is the past participle of vivre. Keep that in mind. You will use this past participle for all the compound tenses in French. J'ai vécu, tu as vécu, il a vécu, nous avons vécu, vous avez vécu, ils ont vécu, elles ont vécu. After that, it's the verb voir. The verb voir, passé composé, j'ai vu. One more time, remember we've got the complément d'objet direct before avoir, and so that's the reason why we need to put the feminine plural form for the past participle vu. And after that, well, it's the verb améliorer in the passé composé, one more time, hein. Ça a amélioré, but then we've got the negative form, ça n'a pas amélioré, and we squeeze the trop, ça n'a pas trop amélioré, but we've got only one verb, a compound verb, and it's amélioré in the passé composé. Voilà. Ainsi, pardon, j'ai ainsi eu, au cours de ma vie, des tas de contacts avec des tas de gens sérieux. J'ai beaucoup vécu chez les grandes personnes. Je les ai vus de très près. Ça n'a pas trop amélioré mon opinion. And that's it. Merci. And let's not forget that if you are in Paris le dimanche 11 juillet à 13h, I will be there. Jardin du Luxembourg. Meet me there. It will be a pleasure. Allez, we continue with la personne du jour. And la personne du jour, eh ben, c'est Mélodie Gardot. Mélodie Gardot, incredible singer, incredible voice, and it's really nice. Allez, on y va. We continue with this sentence. You will have to, well, try to find the missing words. On y va.
J'ai résisté l'appel de l'univers au début. J'ai résisté l'appel de l'univers au début. J'ai résisté l'appel de l'univers au début. J'ai résisté l'appel de l'univers au début.
Allez-y, please write the missing words. Alors, Amla nous rejoint. Bonjour Amla, Luciana is asking for the music. Ah d'accord, I didn't see that, sorry. I will put it after the exercise. Alors, in fact, hein, the words that we had to find was résister, appel, univers, and début. Hein, apparently, you've got it well, more or less correct. So, let's listen to the way she pronounced it, and then probably she's been dropping one thing, I was not sure.
J'ai résisté l'appel de l'univers au début.
Voilà, that's it. So you can see, and it's extremely interesting, because in that case, so I've been correcting the thing. So she's been dropping, she didn't put the preposition a. She says, j'ai résisté l'appel de l'univers au début. But in fact, it's not a problem. And that's exactly what I want to tell you. Don't be stressed to miss or to forget few things from time to time. That's the way it will go, especially for the prepositions, the gender of the words. It is okay. It is okay because we understand. So let's try to listen to it one more time.
J'ai résisté l'appel de l'univers au début.
D'accord. And the fact that it's well pronounced, I mean, clearly it is extremely clear. The pace is quite good. I mean, it's her pace. And really she is pronouncing it quite well. So yes, she's been dropping the A, but it's not the end of the world because we understood exactly what she wanted to say.
J'ai résisté l'appel de l'univers au début.
Voilà, that's it. So it's quite good. Hein? Let's continue with the second thing. Attention, attention, you will have to find all the missing words. I know you can do it.
Mais oui, c'était quelque chose qui a changé beaucoup. Mais oui, c'était quelque chose qui a changé beaucoup. Mais oui, c'était... C'était quelque chose qui a changé beaucoup. Mais oui, c'était quelque chose qui a changé beaucoup. Mais oui, c'était quelque chose qui a changé beaucoup.
Allez-y. Alors, regardons ensemble. So let's have a look at that together. So the structure of the sentence was, mais oui, c'était quelque chose qui a changé beaucoup. Mais oui, c'était quelque chose qui a changé beaucoup. So you've been catching it quite well, in fact. Julia was a bit far for the beginning. She heard ma vie, but it was mais oui. Hein? For the others, yes. I mean, somehow you... Ah, Yesero. Ah oui! Yesero has been putting the Why not? Pourquoi pas? Alors attention, let's go for it. Let's try to see how she pronounces.
Mais oui, c'était quelque chose qui a changé beaucoup.
C'est vrai, Yesero. There is the It's really good. I mean, it is really, really good. It's well pronounced. I think it's extremely clear. The structure is really well constructed. So let's have that one more time. Mais oui... c'était quelque chose qui a changé beaucoup.
Mais oui, c'était quelque chose qui a changé beaucoup.
Voilà, c'est parfait. Hein? It is really good. So, félicitations to her and to you. Numéro 3. Numéro 3, well, it was a bit long, so whether you can rewrite the sentence if you want, or then you can just put the missing words. On y va.
19 ans, j'ai eu un accident grave. J'étais en bicyclette et j'étais renversé par une voiture. 19 ans, j'ai eu un accident grave. J'étais en bicyclette et j'étais renversé par une voiture. 19 ans, j'ai eu un accident grave. J'étais en bicyclette et j'étais renversé par une voiture. 19 ans, j'ai eu un accident grave. J'étais en bicyclette et j'étais renversé par une voiture.
Allez-y. Alors, Sherilyn is the first one because she's fast and efficient. Bravo, bravo, Sherilyn. Alors, let's have a look at the thing. So, I was hiding the number. Of course, you could look at it in the translation, but still, it's up to you. So, 19 was the first one. Grave, it was the second one. Était à bicyclette. So she's been using bicyclette. I told you that in most of the cases nowadays we will use vélo, but if she wants to use bicyclette, it is totally possible and it's nicer. In fact, I think bicyclette is nicer than vélo. So after that, renversé, well, it was the feminine form, and voiture. So let's listen to her pronunciation and let's try to see. There are a few things to say.
19 ans, j'ai eu un accident grave. J'étais en bicyclette et j'étais renversé par une voiture.
Alors, the only thing that maybe she's been doing, and it's quite interesting because she's been doing like French people tend to do now, we use normally, remember that when we are talking about ways of transportation. So if you are in the thing, you should use the preposition en. This is the reason why we say en voiture, en bus, en train, en avion. If you are not in, but you are outside, in that case, you should use à vélo, à moto, etc. But in fact, nowadays, people tend to use the en also for vélo, moto. En vélo, en moto. So she's going for the same thing, hein? En bicyclette. Well, it's technically, grammatically, it's a mistake, but still French people do it, so it's totally acceptable. So j'étais en bicyclette. I wanted to put the correct form just for you, so that you know that it should be à bicyclette. For the rest, it was really, really well pronounced.
19 ans, j'ai eu un accident grave. J'étais en bicyclette et j'étais renversé par une voiture.
Yeah, renversé, she's been taking her time, but clearly it was really, really good. Alors, très bien, félicitations. On y va, numéro 4. Numéro 4, so you will have to find the end. I give you the beginning.
J'ai perdu la possibilité de balader, parler, écouter, voir, lire. J'ai perdu la possibilité de balader, parler, écouter, voir, lire. Que j'ai perdu la possibilité de balader, parler, écouter, voir, lire. Que j'ai perdu la possibilité de balader, parler, écouter, voir, lire. Que j'ai perdu la possibilité de balader, parler, écouter, voir, lire.
Allez-y. Alors, I can see that it's coming quite fast and it's good. In fact, félicitations, c'est très bien. So I've been giving you, in fact, well, as usual, I'm correcting if it needs to be corrected, but still, it's just for you to know exactly how you should put it. So let's listen to her One more time.
Que j'ai perdu la possibilité de balader, parler, écouter, voir, lire.
D'accord. So the first thing that you could notice is the fact that, and that's the reason why I wanted to give you the beginning. Well, in fact, she's using le possibilité instead of la possibilité. It's a classic mistake. I mean, don't worry, it's not something that is problematic. In fact, when you mix and you put the masculine instead of the feminine or vice versa, it's not a problem at all. So this is the point. If, you know, you put the wrong gender in some cases, but really rare cases, you can understand something different. But in most of the cases, it's not a problem. So she just puts le instead of la. So what? It's not the end of the world. After that, she's not putting the me balader. Classic mistake too, because basically people tend to think that balader is like to walk. So promener is like, so, but it, in fact, it's a reflexive verb. So it's se balader, se promener. So you should put the pronoun me balader. Same thing here, we understand everything, so it's not a problem. Of course, we hear that, oh yeah, something is missing, but it's not a problem. It's only a problem for people like me, because that's my job. For the others, they don't care. Allez.
Que j'ai perdu la possibilité de balader, parler, écouter, voir, lire.
Voilà, and she's pronouncing it really, really well. So really, everything is clear. And that's the point. You look at this little thing, well, you get two slight mistakes. So what? Everything is clear and she's continuing her explanation and everything is good for the others. So no problem. Numéro 5. Allez, you will have to get the full thing.
C'était une claque énorme.
Allez-y. Alors, Julia, you didn't like the accent of the queen from yesterday. Alors, attention. So the sentence here, it was, c'était une claque énorme. C'était une claque énorme. So you've been catching the thing quite well. It was, let's listen to it, because in fact, some of you, you've been struggling with the... Well, the article, you went for un instead of une. Maybe she pronounced it. Let's see.
C'était une claque énorme.
Ah, I can see the reason why, yeah.
C'était une claque énorme.
It's true that the une, it's not really like squeezed and clearly pronounced like a une. So it's something that is closer to the un, but not really, because you can feel that there is the un somewhere. But let's listen to that. And I understand now why some of you, in fact, made the mistake.
C'était une claque énorme.
Ouais. So yeah, this is the slight thing that maybe we could comment instead of pronouncing it clearly une, which I would do, c'était une claque énorme. She's pronouncing it closer maybe to un or un. Let's listen to it one more time.
C'était une claque énorme.
D'accord. Well, I can see now. But then, well, c'était une claque énorme, and clearly it was really, really clear. So once again, félicitations, Mélodie. But then apparently we've been crossing the 100, so... Yes. Merci. Allez, so thank you very much. Thank you very much. Don't forget to click if you didn't do it yet. Let's try to see how far we can go. And don't forget to meet me if you are in Paris during July. Le 11 juillet, 13h, Jardin du Luxembourg, I will be there. Allez, la dictée de nombres. As you know, we cannot do one lesson without that if we want to really be specialist and professional. Numéro 1, I will read it only once. 8. 8, it was quite clear in fact. Félicitations, so it's clear, it's on your screen and it's 8. 8 is 8, so let's go for numéro 2, 2 digits and we'll continue. I just pronounce it once, but clearly, 73. Julia has been putting some kind of drawing, but I don't see what it is. What is it? Is it a baby? Is it? I don't really see it. It's not clear. Alors, Olga, if you like this music, you will definitely love Mélodie Gardot. If you don't know her, just try to listen to her. She's so great. Allez, 73, oui, 73, 73, 70, 70, but then obviously after that we need to put the 13, 73. Numéro 3, number 3, and number 3 is obviously with 3 digits. Attention, I will read it only once. 591. You said une huître. I thought it was a baby. Alors, oui, 591, 500, 591, 91, 591, but as I told you, we don't pronounce the k. I did it to be nice, but normally, you will squeeze it and you will pronounce 591. Okay, 591, you don't pronounce the k, 500. 591. Numéro 4. Numéro 4. 4 digits and it's getting more and more difficult. But then in this time, I will pronounce it twice. 7658. 7658. Allez-y. You see, Yulia, Sherilyn, she was just like me. She was lost. We didn't recognize your oyster. It was a strange oyster. Allez, 7658. So 7658. Numéro 5, number 5, will have 5 digits and I will read it twice. 12342. 12342. Allez-y. Yesero, je pensais que c'était une baignoire, but it's clear, it's true that it was not clear. The oyster was not clear. Yesero pensait que c'était une baignoire. Alors, let's have a look at the number. And in that case, it's 12,000. So, 12,342. So, the full thing, 12,342. 12,342. Allez, on continue. Sherilyn, you're like, I think they need to fire the emoji artist. But no! No, it's interesting because we had the chance to talk about it. Allez, 6 digits, and obviously I will read it. I will read it twice. 997,726. 997,726. No, because it's clear, when you look at your thing, it doesn't look like an oyster at all. Alors, let's have a look at the number now. And it's 900, so 997. 997. 1000, obviously. 700, 726. So the full thing, 997,726. 6. Allez, numéro 7, it will be the last one with the million, and of course I will read it twice. 1,111,507. 1,111,507. Allez-y. À Alors, Annabelle was too generous, but we know that Annabelle is extremely generous, so you were a bit too generous for the second part. So in fact, it was not 511, but it was 111. So maybe I was not clear. No, no, there are only two persons, so I guess, no, I had a doubt now after a while. But no, apparently it was clear. Ah, Yesero, too generous too. So, let's see that together. 1 million, that was clear. 111 mille. 1, 1, 1. So, 111, 111. D'accord? 111 mille, of course. 507, 507. So, let's give, let's see the full thing. 1 million, 111 mille, 507. Remember, I should not pronounce the k, but I want to make it clear. And now I will pronounce without stopping, so no k. 1 million, 111 mille, 507. So one more time. 1 million, 111 mille, 507. Voilà. So let's hope it won't rain because I will be there, Jardin du Luxembourg, and I'm waiting for you. Alors, let's continue with la personne du jour. And la personne du jour, well, it's still Mélodie Gardot. And Mélodie Gardot, once again, if you like jazz music and if you want to fall in love with a beautiful, beautiful voice, well, this is the person that you really need to listen to because she's so great. Numéro 1. Allez, I give you the beginning and you give me the end. On y va.
Le destin et aussi le fait que ma mère m'avait donné cette nom, peut-être. Le destin et aussi le fait que ma mère m'avait donné cette nom, peut-être. Le destin et aussi le fait que ma mère m'avait donné cette nom, peut-être. Le destin et aussi le fait que ma mère m'avait donné cette nom, peut-être. Le destin et aussi le fait que ma mère m'avait donné cette nom, peut-être. Le destin et aussi le fait que ma mère m'avait donné cette nom, peut-être.
Allez-y, please, write. Let's have a look at the thing. Soukania, j'ai faim, au revoir. Bon appétit. Bon appétit, Soukania. And it's important to eat, so you should definitely eat. Bon appétit. Allez, so the sentence was les destins et aussi le fait que ma mère m'avait donné ce nom, peut-être. So it's a bit tricky, in fact, because, well, once again, and it's a common thing to make some mistakes with the gender of the words. So, of course, it will impact also, somebody is calling, just 1 second, if it's Nicolas. Ooh, okay, give me 1 little second, please. Merci. Alors, it was Nicolas. Sorry about that. I will come a bit later. So he's coming a bit later. So let's have a look. Yeah, I was mentioning the fact that in that case, if you listen to her, and it's quite interesting, she's mixing once again the gender of the word. So I guess she thinks that non is feminine, which is not really a problem, in fact, because she's not putting ce non, but she's using, once again, let's listen to that.
Le destin et aussi le fait que ma mère m'avait donné cet nom, peut-être.
Voilà. So she's putting cet nom instead of ce nom. But it's not a problem at all. I mean, we understand everything, so it's quite clear. So le destin et aussi le fait que ma mère m'avait donné ce nom, peut-être. D'accord? So one more time, let's listen to her.
Le destin et aussi le fait que ma mère m'avait donné cet nom, peut-être.
Voilà. So this is the only thing that we could, in fact, comment, but it's like nothing, because clearly, as I told you, we do the auto-correction, and in fact, I mean, we understand everything. So numéro 2, you will have to get the whole thing, so try to be brave.
C'était nouveau, et j'étais vraiment comme un bébé. C'était nouveau, et j'étais vraiment comme un bébé. C'était nouveau 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 et j'étais vraiment comme un bébé.
Allez, write it, please. Alors, bonjour Nicolas, bonjour. So we're doing a lesson with Melody Gardot today. So you have to listen to what she says and write the sentences. And once again, Yulia has been putting some things, I don't know. What is it? I mean, what is the drawing? Is it like an oyster again? Alors, Neha is joining us too. Bonjour, bonjour. Allez, let's see the sentence. And if Yulia can answer to the mysterious drawing she's been putting, I would love that. It's not clear. Allez, so c'était nouveau et j'étais vraiment comme un bébé. In fact, you've been catching the thing quite well. So maybe it was because, in fact, it is quite clear. Let's listen to it, but I think it was really clear.
C'était nouveau et j'étais vraiment comme un bébé.
Ouais. And she's really pronouncing it quite clearly. The pace is, I think, extremely good, and it's really, really clear. The only thing, once again, it's for the nasal, but still, I mean, there is nothing to say. We saw that in Marseille, you know, they pronounce it like that. So, I mean, who am I to say that she should pronounce it un instead of un with the little thing? So let's listen to that one more time. My pronunciation is c'était nouveau et j'étais vraiment comme un bébé.
C'était nouveau et j'étais vraiment comme un bébé.
That's it. It's really good. It is really good. I mean, really, this is a great, great pronunciation. And this is one thing that you really should understand. It's you pronounce the way you do. Go for it. And if you will make some mistakes, then what? It's not really a problem. Allez, on y va. You have to give me the full thing now.
Je ne sais pas comment le dire en français. Je 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 sais pas comment le dire en français.
Allez-y. Thank you. Alors, oui, let's have a look at that thing. So, je... Oui, c'est ça. Hein? Non, you've been catching it quite well, in fact. Look, je sais pas. So, once again, you can see that, and this is the way we do it, when it's not formal, we can drop the first part of the negative form. So, she doesn't go for the je ne sais pas. She drops the ne. She squeezes the whole thing. Je sais pas. Comment le dire en français? Je sais pas comment le dire en français. So let's listen to her.
Je sais pas comment le dire en français.
And she's going quite fast, in fact. She's going really, really fast.
Je sais pas comment le dire en français.
That's it. There is nothing to say regarding the pronunciation. It's really good.
Je sais pas comment le dire en français.
Voilà. And this is one thing that is extremely important. Don't be scared to interact with persons. When we discuss with persons, if you don't find the word in French or the structure, ask for them and use English. And after that, you just, you know, involve them in the discussion. So one more time. Je sais pas comment le dire en français. My pronunciation, the way she will pronounce it is...
Je ne sais pas comment le dire en français.
And it's good. It is really, really good. Allez, on continue. Numéro 4, same thing here. You've got to catch all the words from the sentence. Don't look at the translation if you just want to work on the dictation.
Ça, au début, c'était très, très, très difficile. Ça, au début, c'était très, très, très difficile.
Allez-y. Alors, Hilary, she's been putting all the traits, Cassandra too. I'm not really sure, I didn't count them. Let's see what Yesero comes up. If Yesero is still here, he will be probably counting them precisely. Alors, ça, au début, c'était très difficile. Hein? Obviously, she was going for, three or four traits, I don't know. For the thing, it's... Alors, Yesero, he's giving three traits, d'accord, très bien. Merci beaucoup. Let's see how she pronounces the thing, because I think it's quite clear, no, nothing to say.
Ça, au début, c'était très, 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 très difficile.
And this is the interesting thing about it. As I told you, in fact, usually this U sound, and I talked about that yesterday with the Queen. The U is usually quite tricky to master for the English-speaking persons and in some cases also Spanish-speaking persons. So U, because clearly it will be closer to the U than to the U. But in that case, it's extremely, extremely, clean. It's like a real U. Listen to it.
Ça, au début, c'était très, 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 très difficile.
Yeah, the pronunciation is really, really, really good. So, pas de problème. And then Sherilyn thinks that there is four. It goes fast. Let's try to see. Let's count the traits.
Ça, au début, c'était très, 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 très difficile.
Yeah. C'est vrai. Sherilyn was correct. Quel parfait, quelle précision, Sherilyn, bravo. Numéro 5, allez, don't hate me, this one is a bit longer, and try to catch all the words, allez-y.
J'ai presque tombé par terre à cause de cette bruit.
Allez-y.
J'ai
Alors, voilà. As previously, I am offering you here the proper way to structure it. So, because in that case, she's been making two slight mistakes. The first one is, in fact, remember that tomber goes with être when you put that in the compound tenses. So instead of j'ai tombé, we should say je suis tombé. But in fact, and that's one important thing that you need to remember, it's not a problem. Because if she says j'ai tombé, as a French-speaking person, I understand that she wants to say je suis tombé. She's been mixing, she's been putting avoir, and it's not a problem because I understand perfectly the concept. My point is that if you are not sure about using être or avoir, if you've got a doubt, go for avoir and you will be sure that the person will understand you. It won't be a problem to be understood. The person will understand you. If you go in the other direction, you're not really sure and you go with être, this can be tricky. Why? Think about that, the verb inviter. Inviter, just imagine, I've got a doubt. I'm not really sure, I don't remember if inviter is with avoir or être. Obviously, it goes with avoir. It's a regular one, not tricky. So instead of using the structure j'ai invité, I've got a doubt. I think that, okay, I will go with être. Might be the proper thing. I say je suis invité. By doing that, I am using a total different structure. It is this passive form. I am invited. So instead of saying I have invited, I am saying I am invited, which clearly is totally different because basically I am not doing the action in that case. So that's my point. If you have a doubt, go with avoir. Even if you say j'ai allé instead of je suis allé, j'ai tombé like here instead of je suis tombé, I will always understand it. It won't be a problem. And then the second thing is, was, I guess she's been mixing the ce bruit. She's been putting the feminine form, cette bruit. So what? It's not a problem. Let's listen to it one more time.
J'ai tombé par terre à cause de cette bruit. J'ai presque tombé par terre à cause de cette bruit.
Voilà, that's it. Hein? So this is the only thing that maybe we should say. Cette bruit should be ce bruit, and then je suis tombé instead of j'ai tombé. But once again, we understand it without any problem. Voilà, merci beaucoup. Don't forget, July 11th, 1h, Jardin du Luxembourg, I will be there. And let's agree on the fact that this is the last. And it's true, it was a torture for many, many lessons, but this is the last one. It's over. It is over. The book is over. We've been covering all the politeness and good manners rule in France. So once again, it applies only to France. For French people, it's not universal, but still, we'll do it together. Allez, let's have a look and let's start with the first thing. The first thing. Pensez à annoncer votre visite à l'avance, même chez des amis ou de la famille. Pensez à annoncer votre visite à l'avance, même chez des amis ou de la famille. Alors, Nicolas Grimaldi, you know what? You've got the same name as my son, Nicolas, and I love this name. Merci beaucoup. This one is for you. Merci, Nicolas. Merci beaucoup. Eh oui, you know what Nicolas Grimaldi, only great persons have Nicolas as the first name. Eh oui, it's so beautiful. Allez, let's have a look at the missing things. The first one, it was annoncé. It should be in the infinitive form, remember. Once again, this is quite interesting, pensez à faire, try to put that on your list if you make a list of verbs, because in that case you can see that this verb, penser à, in fact, is followed by the infinitive. My monitor is switching off, but it's okay. Annoncer, you will write it A-N-N-O-N-C-E-R. After that, visite. Remember, visite is a substantive, it's a noun, it's a feminine noun. Une visite, la visite, and you write it V-I-S-I-T-E. Avance, you've been writing it quite well, in fact, and you write it A-V-A-N-C-E. And I need to press here. Chez was written properly, C-H-E-Z, yes. And finally, famille, substantive, it's a noun and it's feminine. Une famille, la famille, F-A-M-I-L-L-E. Pensez à annoncer votre visite à l'avance, même chez des amis ou de la famille. This is quite important, depending after that where you're going. And in the South, it's a bit more relaxed regarding this rule, but still, it should be like that. Asseyez-vous au fond de votre siège. I've been hearing that all my childhood. Asseyez-vous au fond de votre siège. Please write the sentence. Alors, let's have a look at the sentence. So it's asseyez. Look, the way to write it properly. So it's A-S-S-E-Y-E-Z. And after that, you need to put vous. Sherilyn, but what if you're too short? No, it's possible. You don't need to put the feet on the ground. It's not possible. Technically, it's not possible. But at least you should go all the way au fond du siège, c'est comme ça. Fond, F-O-N-D, this is the way it is written. And then siège, it's a masculine word, un siège. And it's written S-I-E, accent grave, G-E. Asseyez-vous au fond de votre siège. Let's have a look at numéro 3. Numéro 3, on y va. So this one is a long one. Dans les transports en commun, offrez toujours votre place aux femmes enceintes. Dans les transports en commun, offrez toujours votre place aux femmes enceintes. Allez-y. Oh là là, Victoria Jacques, I am on vacation and I am in the sun and I will try to catch as much as I can. Relax, Victoria Jacques, you need to enjoy the sun. If you've got the sun, catch everything for us. Allez, on regarde ensemble, so let's have a look at the things. So, dans les transports, transport, remember that it's a masculine word, but in that case, it's the plural form, so T-R-A-N-S-P-O-R-T-S. En commun, remember, hein, that's, this is the way we express when we're talking about the public transportation, it's transport en commun. Commun, C-O-M-M-U-N. Offrez should be here in the imperative form, and once again, we're using the imperative for all these series, even if it's the end now. It is the end of the good manners. Offrez, you write it O-F-F-R-E-Z. Toujours, so you write it quite well in that case. Votre place, remember, place is feminine. Une place, la place. Femmes enceintes, you should put that in the plural form, so O-A-U-X, remember that is that, it's the compression of A and LE, and it becomes O, and femme with the plural form, enceinte, same thing here. Dans les transports en commun, offrez toujours votre place aux femmes enceintes. Stardust was missing enceinte, enceinte pregnant, hein? Enceinte, in that case, you should put that in a plural form, so E-N-C-E-I-N-T. T-E-S. Allez, let's continue. Numéro 4. Numéro 4. And Stardust, it's the end. It's the end. Only two. And after that, we're done with the good manners. I'm pretty sure that you will miss them. You will miss them, you see. I give you the beginning. Give me the last part. Si vous êtes invité quelque part à dîner, arrivez avec 10 ou 15 minutes de retard. Si vous êtes invité quelque part à dîner, arrivez avec 10 ou 15 minutes de retard. Allez-y. Alors, let's have a look at the thing. So it was, and it's quite interesting, and we'll have to discuss about that one time. But this is the, I mean, it's really the case. It is really the case. So let's go first to the things that we were supposed to find. So arriver clearly should be in the imperative form for the second person of the plural, arriver, A-R-R-I-V-E-Z. For the rest, it's quite simple, 10 ou 15. Minutes should be in the plural form, and then retard, hein, remember that you write it, R-E-T-A-R-D. Si vous êtes invité quelque part à dîner, arrivez avec 10 ou 15 minutes de retard. And so that's one important thing. If you are invited to someone's place, you don't arrive on time. If you're invited at 7, 8, 9, you arrive at least with 10 to 15 minutes after. This is just the way it is. It's for you. If you arrive on time, maybe the person will still be in the shower. You don't know. Allez. Numéro 5, and it's the last one. Oh, it is the last one. It's the last one. And I think we saw it already. But still, let's enjoy it. ne dévisagez jamais une personne. Ne dévisagez jamais une personne. Allez-y. Alors, Stardust Late, in Germany it's the opposite. Yeah, I know. In the Nordic countries it's the same, You're supposed to arrive, I mean, on time, or then slightly earlier, or a bit later, but this is the way it goes. Sherilyn, they're always on time. I'm talking about informal, if you invite people at home to eat or something like that. For the meetings, for the business, it's slightly different. Amla, we agree that we're talking about when you invite somebody to eat, it's for dinner. We're not talking about having some kind of business meeting or professional meeting, because in that case, of course, you need to be on time. We were talking about this informal context or situations. Ali, that was the last one. This is the last one, mesdames et messieurs. And after that, we're done. We've been covering, I don't know, I think it was more than 300 things regarding politeness and good manners. So you are specialist now. Ne dévisagez. Dévisagez is the verb, in fact, from the first group in that case. As you can see, it's in the imperative and it's the negative form. Ne jamais. This is the way we structure it. Une personne. So never stare at a person, especially if you're in the public transportation. Don't do that, especially in Paris. You might end up in tricky situations. Be careful. Ne dévisagez jamais une personne. Allez, once again, Paris, 11 juillet, 13h, Jardin du Luxembourg, I am waiting for you. Allez, let's finish with la personne du jour, one more time, Mélodie Gardot, such a beautiful voice. I think it is extremely interesting to work on the things that she says. Let's go for it. Now you've got to find everything.
J'ai passé quelques mois dans une université à Maryland. J'ai passé quelques mois dans une université à Maryland. J'ai passé quelques mois dans une université à Maryland. J'ai passé quelques mois dans une université à Maryland. J'ai passé quelques mois dans une université à Maryland. J'ai passé quelques mois dans une université à Maryland.
Allez-y. Alors, let's have a look at the thing. So, once again, I've been correcting what was needed, and in that case, it was the preposition. So, and normally it goes with O, in fact. So, remember that, in fact, when it comes to the states, American states, in that case, it will be exactly the same thing as with the countries. So, it means that if, in fact, it ends with a, In that case, it will be feminine. En Californie, en Floride, because you've got this final if it doesn't, then in that case, it will be masculine. Au Maryland, au Texas. So you see, this is exactly the same way as we have for the countries. En with the feminine, au with the masculine. This is just a rule. That's just the way it goes. In that case, Maryland is masculine, so it means that it will be with O. So, j'ai passé quelques mois dans une université au Maryland. So, it was the only mistake, but still, it's the same. It's not really a mistake. If you think about that, everyone understands the thing. So, let's go for it and let's see.
J'ai passé quelques mois dans une université à Maryland.
It's really well pronounced. She's making this beautiful liaison dans une université. So clearly it is really, really clean, really proper. So one more time. J'ai passé quelques mois dans une université au Maryland.
J'ai passé quelques mois dans une université à Maryland.
Et voilà, effectivement, effectivement. Alors, Shailene is talking about her colleagues who have been... Ah, that's the tricky thing. If you stay too long in a country, after that, you get absorbed by the culture of the country where you are. Allez, on y va, on y va. Now you get to find all the words.
Pour réadapter mes oreilles après. 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 Pour réadapter mes oreilles après.
Allez-y. Yesero, mon, tout le plaisir est pour moi. Yeah, it's the same concept as for the countries, in fact. Alors, be careful, Yesero, of course, for the countries. I mean, we're talking about French language. We've got few exceptions, obviously, but that's the main rule. Alors voilà, hein. So the sentence was pour réadapter mes oreilles après. Pour réadapter mes oreilles après. So let's see, because it seems that you've been catching it quite well. In fact, félicitations.
Pour réadapter mes oreilles après.
And everything is really, really properly pronounced. She's putting the liaison, mes oreilles. The pace is quite good. Everything is pronounced perfectly.
Pour réadapter mes oreilles après.
Oui, this is really, really good. Hein? So it's a good example just to show that, you know, it's possible to really pronounce quite well. So let's go for the next one. Allez-y.
Et moi, j'ai perçu tous les détails. 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 Et moi, j'ai perçu tous les détails.
Allez-y. Alors, let's have a look at the thing. So, et moi, j'ai perçu tous les détails. So, I'm looking at your things. It's quite good, in fact. Be careful. So, it's really interesting because you can see that she's mastering it well, quite well, because she went for the verb percevoir. Percevoir, she's putting that in the passé composé form. J'ai perçu. It's quite good. tous les détails. So she's been putting, in fact, the proper gender for détail. Let's go for it.
Et moi, j'ai perçu tous les détails.
Voilà, same thing here, extremely well pronounced.
Et moi, j'ai perçu tous les détails.
Je dis bravo. Bravo, Mélodie, c'est formidable. Let's go for numéro 4. Let's see if you can make it. You've got the full sentence.
Ça veut dire c'était gênant de sortir. 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 Ça veut dire c'était gênant de sortir.
Allez-y. Ah, excuse, mais où est la politesse? Moi, je... Mais je sais! Je sais! I'm not saying anything, Ice Cubes. I am not commenting these beautiful things, but I've got my opinion on that. Allez, let's have a look at the thing. So, ça veut dire que c'était gênant de sortir. So, you've been catching it quite well, in fact, hein? And I think it was extremely clear. So, let's listen to it one more time.
Ça veut dire c'était gênant de sortir.
Okay, you can see that one more time, in fact, she's been dropping the que. If you listen carefully, she says ça veut dire c'était gênant de sortir.
Ça veut dire c'était gênant de sortir.
Voilà, same thing here. Of course, I mean, you should put the que, hein, and in most of the cases, you've been putting it. So, ça veut dire que, it should be here, and after that you continue, c'était gênant de sortir. But it's a good example. It means that even if she drops it, I understand the full thing. So, this que, in fact, is not really, really a problem if you miss it. Of course, it should be there. Of course, if you want to use French properly, it should be there in the construction. But if, by accident, or if you don't remember, you drop it, then the meaning is still the same. We understand the thing. So, ça veut dire que c'était gênant de sortir. Let's listen to it one more time.
Ça veut dire c'était gênant de sortir.
Voilà. Because everything is so clear that even if she drops it, it's not really, really a problem. Allez, let's finish with numéro 5. It's a big one, but then you can make it. Allez-y.
C'était gênant d'aller dans un resto, c'était pas possible d'aller dans un supermarché. C'était gênant d'aller dans un resto, c'était pas possible d'aller dans un supermarché. C'était gênant d'aller dans un resto, c'était pas possible d'aller dans un supermarché. C'était gênant d'aller dans un resto, c'était pas possible d'aller dans un supermarché. C'était gênant d'aller dans un resto, c'était pas possible d'aller dans un supermarché. C'était gênant d'aller dans un resto, c'était pas possible d'aller dans un supermarché.
Allez-y. Alors, Chélina, I guess that Brigitte Bardot song, moi je joue, isn't very polite. Well, let's agree on the fact that Cherilyn, I mean, Brigitte Bardot, is not considered to be one of the main representatives of politeness and good manners. Alors, Félicitations. So now you can see that you totally got adapted to her way of, well, speaking, because in fact, you caught everything. So look, and it was, I think, extremely clear.
C'était gênant d'aller dans un resto, c'était pas possible d'aller dans un supermarché.
It's really, it is really, really well pronounced. I mean, there is nothing to say, in fact.
C'était gênant d'aller dans un resto, c'était pas possible d'aller dans un supermarché.
Yeah, the pace is good, the intonation is good, she's pronouncing, well, she's got a slight accent, but it is good and it is really nice, in fact. So, félicitations, one more time. Let's listen to that just for the pleasure.
C'était gênant d'aller dans un resto, c'était pas possible d'aller dans un supermarché.
Eh ben voilà. And that's it. And that was,
c'était
in
gênant
fact...
d'aller...
No! Let's not forget that! Dimanche 11 juillet, 13h, Jardin du Luxembourg. Look at the blinking arrow. I will be exactly there. And I'm waiting for you. So let's not forget the last thing. And well, it's the quote of the day. Chaque baiser est une fleur dont la racine est ton cœur. This is so beautiful. Chaque baiser est une fleur dont la racine est ton cœur. Cœur. Merci beaucoup. See you tomorrow. Tomorrow we'll work with Céline Dion, so we'll work a bit on the Canadian or Quebec accent. Voilà, merci. Au revoir.
Thank you.